morning students. Now today we are going to start our 8th lecture of chapter 10, that is alternating current. And yesterday we have completed the topics of RC circuit. Okay, in that all the phasor diagram, impedance diagram, all the things we have prepared. Clear? Now we are just moving towards the next topic, and that is your LCR series AC circuit. And in this, as I told you, that as this I have just given you for your homework also, that you have to be solved. I have just made the circuit diagram and given you the homework that you have to be try to solve about it. And I hope that you all have tried. Okay, now we are starting this LCR topic. Okay, now in the LCR series AC circuit, remember the most important thing is that all the circuits LR and RC and LCR, all these are in series combination. Clear? Now in this we are going to start. The first of all, I just will write some of the theoretical portion of this circuit diagram, so it will be help you out. Okay, anyone in the exam also, when the question will be come in front of you, that describe this and that. So you have to be first explained by in the theoretical way. You have to be explained the circuit diagram first of all. Then you have to be moved towards derivation portion. Okay, not do the directly the derivations. No. Okay. So in this, the AC voltage V is equals to Vm sin omega t. This we are using, beta, is applied to the series LCR circuit. Series LCR circuit. Okay? And at any instant, which instant beta? T. At any instant T, the current in the circuit is I. This current is flowing in the circuit. Okay, the voltage developed across the elements. Which elements we have? Resistance R, capacitance C, and inductance L. Okay, is voltage drop across the resistance is your VR, across the inductance is your VL, and across the capacitance is your VC. Okay, and what is discussing about that is your VR minus IR, VL minus, when we apply the Kirchhoff's law, okay, IXL, and VC is equal, VC minus IXC. Clear? So when we discuss about the net voltage, so the net voltage developed across the series combination. Okay? Developed across the series combination. And that net voltage is your beta VLCR. Okay, now we have to be apply the Kirchhoff's law for the further solution. Okay, so if you are applying the Kirchhoff's law, so from Kirchhoff's loaf, we get V minus V LCR is equals to 0. So first of all, we have to draw the phasor diagram so we can easily identify them. So I am just drawing the phasor diagram beta. Just have a look here like this. So on this way is your current, the maximum value of the current. Now in the inductance, it is the voltage will be 90 degree leading ahead, and in the capacitance the voltage is 90 degree lag behind. Okay, and this one is the resultant, and resultant is your VMLCR. And what does we leading ahead with the making an angle phi. Clear? Now just you know that in the current, in the resistance, the current and voltage both are in the same way. So VMR, in the resistance the current and the voltage are in the same direction. In the inductor, the voltage is 90 degree leading ahead with the current, and in the capacitance the voltage is 90 degree lag behind the current. Clear? So all these things are there. I have just been plotted here, the draw the line perpendicular. So up to here, this is we have just taken VML minus VMC. What is this? This is the phasor diagram. And why I have written it as VML minus VMC? Because we have just taken that this phasor diagram is from that the XL is greater than the XC. XL is greater than the XC. That's why we have used here. Okay. So now from this phasor diagram we see that the VMR is in the phase with the IM, while the VML is leads the current by 90 degree, and VMC is lags the current by pi by 2. Now the voltage across the inductor and the capacitor are just opposite to each other. Okay, here I am not denoting all these things because all these things are written shown in the diagram. I am just discuss about the this portion, this condition. Okay, so the voltage across L and C are opposite to each other. Hence, what we can say that the VLC is greater VML minus VMC, and which is perpendicular to VMR. To this, it is perpendicular to VMR. Okay, moving ahead, this condition we are just taken only for which beta? Only for the for XL greater than XC. Remember this thing. This is only for the XL greater than XC. Now we have to be applied the formula. So first of all, we have to be calculate the resultant value beta. So what is the resultant value beta? VMLCR is equals to under the root of VMR and VMLC whole square and addition. So VMR to the square plus VML minus VMC to the square and under the root. This is will be your equation number 1 I am denoting here. Now you know all the values. Okay, what is the value of VMR according to the Ohm's law? IMR, VML, IM, XL, inductive reactance, V and C is equals to I m into xc. Okay? So I have just put all these values in the equation number 1, then we get it up. What? V m l c r is equals to under the root. Value of VMR is IM into R to the square. VML is your IM into XL minus VMC IM into XC to the square, and the whole under root is there. So I am just taking IM as a constant in the front. So VMLCR is equals to IM when I am just taking it to common with R. So the square is there and the square has been cancelled out with the under root. So only IM with that. Okay? So multiply with the remaining portion R square plus XL minus XC square to the under root. This equation we get, equation number 2. Now we have to get the value of, from here, IM. We have to calculate the value of IM. So from here, IM is equals to VMLCR upon under the root R square plus XL minus XC square. Equation number 3. Now, if we have just discussed that this value, under the root R square plus XL minus XC to the whole square, this is the entire, the whole resistance which is been applied in the LCR series AC circuit. And you know it very well, the entire, the whole resistance which is applied in the circuit, that is known as impedance. Okay, means in the LR circuit, the impedance value is under the root R square plus XL square. And in the RC circuit, the value of impedance Z is equals to under the root R square plus XC square. And in the LCR circuit, the value of the impedance is R square plus XL minus XC to the square. This is equals to Z. Okay, and what is this? It is the effective resistance of the series combination and is called, what is called beta? What is that known impedance? Called impedance of the circuit. Clear? Okay. Now moving further with this. So we have just calculated the value of impedance. Z is equals to the value of impedance for the LCR circuit beta. Just remember the formula. R square plus XL minus XC to the square under the root. This will be equation number 4. Now we have to calculate the value of tan phi. Just remember the diagram, the phasor diagram. What? Vertical XL minus XC upon horizontal R. Okay? Clear? So from here, this is the value of beta angle phi. This is your equation number 5. Clear? Now, what we have to do? We have to just simply put the value of XL and XC, and I know you know the value of XL. XL is your omega L, XC is your 1 upon omega C. So Z is equals to under the root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C to the square under the root equation number 6. And how it is come beta? XL is equals to omega L, XC is equals to 1 upon omega C due to this. Clear? Okay. Now, from here, we have know that the how much it was lagging and how much it was leading, because this concept we already understand in our previous individual circuit. Okay. So, the current IM lags the voltage VCR by an angle phi. We have made in the phasor diagram, beta, and we have just taken the condition that if XC is greater than XL, it's a different condition we have taken, beta, because previously we have taken the condition XL is greater than XC, but now if we are taking the condition XC is greater than XL, then what happen? Its potential is also be greater than the potential of the inductor, and at that time the current will lead the voltage. Why I have written here, beta? Because in the previous condition XL is greater than XC. On that time XL is leading the, in the XL the current is 90 degree lag behind the potential. But if we are just taking the condition of XC is greater than XL, then in this remaining, beta, in the diagram XC is on the downside, beta. It means the voltage, the current is 90 degree leading. It means the voltage is 90 degree lag behind. Simple as that. Okay. Now we have to calculate the tan phi value for this. So angle tan phi is equals to, as I just told you, beta, what is the value of it? XL minus XC upon R. So from here, the angle phi is equals to tan inverse XL minus XC upon R. Equation number 7. Okay, so all the value of the phi and the Z impedance is all depends upon the, well, three elements: resistance, okay, inductive reactance, and the capacitive reactance R, XL, and XC. Remember this thing. Okay, moving ahead in this topic, we are just to solve some special conditions. Some special conditions which we are going to solve. So your first condition in this series is, we are just taking that if VML is greater than VMC. Okay, so for this we know, beta, if VML is greater than VMC, then its reactance is also be greater than the capacitive reactance. Okay, now we have to calculate the value of impedance, beta. So what is the formula? Without seeing this, write down the formula, beta. R square plus XL minus XC square under the root. Okay, now, and what is the formula of tan phi? Phi, beta. Just tell me fastly. Tan inverse XL minus XC upon R. Okay, and in this we have to write all the things and we have to put all these values. Clear? So now from the phasor diagram, always remember the value of the value of phi will be positive and have the value between where to where, beta? 0 to pi by 2. And the circuit will be what? The circuit will behave like your LR circuit, and the current is lags the potential. Okay, and in this condition the impedance, the AC voltage and the current are given by the phasor diagram, and the current in the circuit, what would the current, beta? It was be lagging behind. Okay, so the current in the circuit is I is equals to I am sine omega t minus phi. Clear? Okay, so I am just drawing the diagram, the impedance diagram and the phasor diagram for all these things. Okay, so let's draw the diagram. First of all, I am just plotting the graph which I have already plotted, but this time I am plotting for the impedance. Okay, so origin, this is for the XL, this is for the XC reactance, and this is for the resistance, because I am just plotting this for the condition XL is greater than XC, and this is the impedance diagram, so only the terms which is used in the impedance that we are only utilizing in this diagram. Okay, so what was that? Suppose this is going to the resultant one impedance up to A, and it's making an angle phi. So when we plot here, this will be your resistance, and here this will be your the difference XL minus XC, because XL is greater than XC. Clear? Okay, this we have been used. And when we are moving toward the next one, so for the next one, beta, I am just again plotting the phasor diagram for XL minus XC, the same condition, I am taking it out. Okay, and here it is between R and X, both that we are using. Okay, so first of all, if I am discussing about the value of the value of Vm, so here it is about of Vm LCR by moving ahead the value. Suppose this will be the value. Of VMR, okay, and it was ahead with the angle phi on the same direction IM is moving, and with respect to this IM, here is the value. This is makes the angle pi by 2, and it is of your VML minus VMC. So I am just joining all these lines, and okay, all these lines. It is just be about 90 degrees. Okay, clear? So all this, like this diagram you are having. Okay, and this one is your which diagram, beta? This one is your phasor diagram. Of XL greater than X. Okay. Clear? So this we have done. Now moving towards the second condition, the special condition which we are talking, which we are proceeding with now. And the second condition, this condition I am just writing, okay, and giving you for your homework with now. And the condition is that if XC greater than XL and VMC is greater than VMM, okay, then the value of Z will be beta. If I am taking this condition, R square plus XC minus XL square. When XL is greater than XL, XL minus XL, the greater one will become first. Okay, and for that the value of phi will be beta. What? Previously when XL is greater than XC, sorry, here XL I have written. Previously when the XL is greater than XC, so XL minus XL for R. And for the XC greater than XL, then it will be XC minus XL upon R. So for this condition, you have to be calculate the value of I, plot the impedance diagram and the phasor diagram as well. Okay, all these things you have to be do. Okay, and in the third condition which you have to be solved is if you just be remember that the when XL is greater than XC. Okay. Third one condition that you also you have to be tried, that is if XL is equals to XC, then VML is equals to VMC. These two you have to be solved, you have to be tried. Clear? Okay, so this is your homework. These two conditions you have to be tried at your home, and further we are proceeding in our tomorrow's lecture. Okay, thank you. That's all for today.